Our next section talks about passive transport. Now, passive transport is going to be the movement of molecules from areas of high concentration to low concentrations. This here is what we're talking about with a concentration gradient. It's going to start out with high concentrations right here, and then you can see it's going to diffuse and move from areas of high concentration to areas of where we have equal but lower concentrations. You can see these molecules start out at a high concentration, and now they're moving out and they're spreading out. And now the concentration is going to be much lower, but evenly spread out throughout this box. Diffusion is when this occurs on its own, and they're just molecules moving and spreading out. This is like if somebody sprays Axe in a locker room, instantly the whole locker room smells like Axe because these molecules are moving from areas of high concentration where it was sprayed to areas of low concentration, and it evens out throughout time. Osmosis is when you have diffusion of water molecules. So we talked about that selectively permeable membrane of cells. This diffusion of water is known as osmosis. Now, again, the movement's going to be from areas of high concentration to areas of low concentration. And we see the same things, but water here is going to be moving freely across the membrane, not the molecules. So again, molecules don't move across, the water does. We have three different types of solutions. Three solutions that these osmotic movements create are called hypotonic solutions, isotonic, and hypertonic. I know I go over these with my 9th and 10th graders, so you should remember these from a couple years ago. Hypotonic, I remember this O, it makes the cell really big because water is rushing into the cell. Isotonic is just the one that's in the middle. Water evenly goes into and out of the cell. Hypertonic is when you have a cell that's very small because water has left the cell. I think of like a little brother or sister that's hypertonic, they're small. Think about that hypertonic solution. Here we have the isotonic solution. You can see here where water is going to enter and leave the cell. That means water concentrations to begin with were even on both sides. This is that hypotonic solution that I talked about first. You can see the cell has swelled. You can see that O that I talk about, hypo. It's because water concentrations were higher on the outside compared with the inside to start. That means water is going to move from high to low concentrations here. Here we have that hypertonic solution. Water is going to move out of the cell because we had more water inside the cell than outside the cell. Another aspect of osmosis is plasmolysis, which is just when the cytoplasm of a cell is going to shrink due to osmosis. This is because they've been put in a hypertonic solution. Again, that's a hypertonic solution. Water is going to leave the cell because there's more water to begin with inside the cytoplasm than outside. So it means water is going to be leaving, which means the cytoplasm is going to shrink. Our next and last passive transport is called facilitated diffusion. So we had diffusion, which is just the movement of molecules. We had osmosis, which is the movement of water molecules. Facilitated diffusion does the same thing, but a little bit differently. You can see here diffusion is moving from high to low concentrations. Facilitated diffusion does the same thing. We're still moving from high to lower concentrations. We're doing this through a membrane protein. We talked about how those channel and carrier proteins in the last section, these are going to aid us in that high to low concentration gradient. So again, you can see here the molecules are still moving in a high to low concentration gradient, but they're moving through membrane proteins.